rainbow straw lab. The second lab I'm just going to call the red, white, and clear, or red, blue, and clear lab. Okay? How is the red, blue, and clear lab different from our rainbow straw lab? What were some differences? Discuss with your table partner. Go. So let's go ahead and read through what we also just think about the properties of a liquid versus a gas can change volume. That's what you're doing when you're changing the density of a gas. You're changing its volume. Liquids can't change volume, okay? So we can't change the density of a liquid through force because we can't make it be a different volume ourselves. What about temperature? Can we use temperature to change the density in both a liquid and a gas? Yes, correct. Less dense.
kinetic energy to particles, and they will move fast.
Great. So heat. Gives energy to particles, causing them to move faster. When they move faster, what happens, Vera?
They bump into each other.
Great. When they collide, moving fast, they collide with greater what, Vera?
Greater particles.
That last word that you had talked about in your original answer, they collide with greater
temperature.
No. When they bump into each other, they're bumping into each other with greater what? The faster they go, the greater
force.
Force. Yes, with greater force. Now, Mark, what happens then?
Oh, I was thinking.
You're the second part of my mega answer. What happens after that? No, you really are the second part of my mega answer. So read me your answer now.
They go further apart from each other.
Excellent. When they collide with greater force, they go further apart from each other, causing them to become what? Excellent. You need both parts of this answer. You need both Federon and Mark's answers combined together to have a complete and thorough answer. Now the evidence, what is the evidence? Where did we see this happen? Where did we see this happen? The best example that we saw it happen in is what? Stella?
In our red, clear, and blue water lab.
Excellent. In our red, clear, and blue water lab, and you could have explained that in any way you want. In my original exemplar, I said the hottest water was doing what? What do we see the hottest water do? So,
sitting on top of the other colors.
It sat on top of the other colors. What did the coldest water do? The sun? It was the bottom layer. Excellent. All right. Look at the bottom of the page after you've completed putting together our two answers to create your mega answer. And look at that vocab word. Read through it quickly. How is it different than the convection that we talked about in Unit 2? Because we talked about convection in Unit 2. How is it different than how we talked about convection in Unit 2? You're almost so far, or it's a good time to use the restroom. Almost so far. How is it different? Okay.
It's different because in Unit 2, we talked about convection as a current for density, but here it's talking about it being motions, masses of streams for density, and caused by different densities.
Excellent. In Unit 2, it was all about what type of transfer? Julia?
Like radiation.
Radiation was an example, convection was an example, and collision, which is actually called what? Brain? Mm-hmm. Conduction. That's all types of what type of transfer? What type of transfer, Murray? Thermal energy transfer, heat transfer, right? When we talk about convection, why do we think we're talking about convection in Unit 3? What is Unit 3 about? What is Unit 3 about? Think back to our first week. I know you might not be sure yet what Unit 3 is about, but what is Unit 3 about, Lila?
Weather.
So we want to understand, how does convection impact weather? And when we talk about how convection impacts weather, it's important that we zoom in on the movement of masses of fluid, so masses of air or water, or streams of air or water. And the reason those masses are going to move is because they have different locations.
They have different temperatures.
Exactly. They have different temperatures, which means densities. Excellent. All right, flip to page 4. right, check me in 5, 4. Go ahead. everyone is skipping to density of air on page 7. Read from density of air through the end of the article and then answer the questions. Everyone is at page 7, reading density of air and moving through the end of the article.
but it lights a fire that heats up the particles, and the particles rise up toward the cloth or whatever it is.
Let's go back to what we read about happens when we increase the energy of particles. What do they start doing? How do they move differently?
When we increase the temperatures, they rise because of convection.
I don't want you skipping ahead to that. We need to understand first, what do the particles do right when we add that energy? When we add heat, how do the particles move differently?
They start to move faster.
Perfect. They move faster. When they move faster, what happens when they bump into each other?
They gain force.
Right. They're going to collide with each other with greater force, which means what happens when after they collide with each other with greater force, Nate? What's the effect of greater force in a collision?
The particles move back
farther. Important word you added on in the end there. Particles, when they bounce off each other, they bounce off further from each other, creating more space between the particles. When the particles have more space between them, what happens to the air?